Everybody, I'm Tyler from Viavi Solutions, and in this episode, I'm talking with Ed Gassel. He's our product line manager for many of our fiber optic test equipment, and he also oversees many of our MPO test instruments. And so I wanted to have some time to talk with him a little bit about the different portfolio that we have and what testing is used and when. So Ed, thanks for being on with us.
Thanks, Tyler. So
tell us a little bit when it comes to MPO testing. I know it's been around for a long time, but a lot of folks who are getting into this are asking, okay, what do I need? What kind of test equipment do I need for MPO?
Yeah, and MPO testing is not that much different than regular duplex fiber testing in the sense of what tests need to be performed. Obviously, the testers are somewhat different. So for the tests that you need to perform, you've got your straight-on inspection of the fiber end faces, and of course it's typically a 12 fiber ferrule that you have to inspect. You've got your tier one or basic certification, which is your lost length and polarity. And you also have your tier two or your enhanced testing, which is performing OTDR tests so that you can really see each individual event in that fiber link. So it's the exact same that you would see for duplex testing. It's just that your tools have to be different because you've got a different fiber connector, being that MPO connector.
Great, yeah. So when we've talked a lot, obviously, about fiber inspection and other episodes and such, but I want to ask a little bit more about when it comes to, you talked about length loss and polarity, differentiating when to use a typical MPO to MPO test versus maybe, I know there's applications where MPO is a subset of a greater length. Can you talk a little bit more about when you'd need to use direct MPO testing versus others?
Yes, and so this is, MPO really has been in networks for quite some time, and it's been used as a backbone or a trunk. And when you have that backbone or a trunk, then you'll typically have something like a cassette to break down into individual LCs. And that still exists, and that will get you up, in today's world with multi-mode, will get you up to 10 gig. If you start to go beyond 10 gig, then you start to need to have different types of connectors out at the end. Yeah, so that's, you know, this is your cassette. You've got your 24 fibers coming in at the back through MPO, and these need to be inspected. But then your test is done with a classic OLTS by testing each of the individual LC drops. So in this case, you really don't need to test the trunk assembly. If you do need to troubleshoot it, that's where an OTDR would come into play, and then you can look to find out where a specific fault is. But, you know, typically with those trunk assemblies, your issue is your connections that you have, the MPO connections. So then when things start to get different is where you're running at, especially with multi-mode, 40 and 100 gig, and there are systems like PSM4 for single mode that also run what I would call native MPO right into the equipment, whether it's a switch, a router, a server type of thing. And for that, then you need to start having native MPO interfaces on your test equipment, which allow you to test those links and channels. And so that's what the MPO-LX does, is your basic or tier one certification, your loss length and polarity. And it's done really much the same way that you would do with an OLTS on LC links, is you do a set reference, you set a limit, and then you connect up to your system that you're testing, you perform the test, you get pass-fail, except you're doing a pass-fail on 12 fibers now instead of two.
Gotcha. Okay, so very similar behavior. It's still an optical loss test set.
Exactly.
Now, you said this is more prevalent when you get into that 40 gig, 100 gig with QSFPs and such.
With QSFPs, where you've got that direct QSFP or MPO connection into your switch and servers, that's where you need to be. Your link itself, instead of being a duplex LC, your link is an MPO, typically a 12 fiber MPO. And that's why you need to test that link with native MPO testing. Or you can test the channel as well, disconnect from the QSFP plugged into the switch, server, router, whatever, and then test the channel.
Okay. Yeah. Now, you had briefly mentioned the tier two or enhanced testing as well, finding out more information. Can you talk a little bit more about some of the new technologies with being able to test an MPO individual lanes with an OTDR?
So with our 4000 platform, we have a switch module for it. And so your OTDR is still a simplex connection, but the simplex connection goes to the switch, and the switch gives you that 12-fiber MPO out. And because the switch module and the OTDR module are both on the same device, it's really automated. So you say what you want to test. I want to test all 12 fibers. You hit start, and the OTDR tests fiber number one. The switch switches to fiber number two, test fiber number two, and so on. So you just start it, step back, and let it go through all 12 fibers by stepping through with the switch.
And again, like any OTDR, that gives you the benefit of seeing each individual event through that entire...
Correct, yes. And with modern OTDRs, you're certainly the 4000, is that you're then seeing a schematic view so that you see what the events are and which events have a problem with it, instead of having to read a squiggly line on the screen.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
Well, hey, thanks again for joining us, Ed. You also recently wrote a white paper goes into greater depth on this.
Yes.
For more information and to get that white paper that Ed wrote, you can visit us online at viavisolutions.com/MPO. Thanks for watching.